Welcome to the lecture series of finite element analysis. This is Dr. Manoj Kumbhalkar. In the today's lecture, we will discuss about static stress concentration factor calculation for a plate with center hole subjected to axial loading in tension or compression using FEA software. So, in the today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the practical over ANSYS software for the plate with hole. So this is the given problem, having plate with dimensions 100 mm by 50 mm with the center with the hole at center and also besides. The diameter of the hole at the center is 15 mm and the diameter of the holes beside the center hole is 10 mm. The load applied over the plate is 1000 newton and the material properties given are Young's modulus is equals to 200 gigapascal and Poisson's ratio is 0.3, which is nothing but the property of structural steel. So this is the GOI of the ANSYS. So here you can see the static structural analysis where there are total 6 steps, that is engineering data, geometry, model, setup, solution, results. So if we go step by step, the complete analysis procedure is given here. So first of all, the engineering data. So what is engineering data? Here the material properties we can provide the material properties for the component, for the model for which we have to do the analysis. Thereafter, the geometry, the second step is to prepare a geometry for which you will going to do the stress analysis or the displacement, you are going to find out the displacement. Then third is the model, that is nothing but the meshing. Here we have to divide the body into the number of parts, that is in the number of element and nodes. Fourth is the static structural, which is nothing but to apply the boundary condition. Fifth is solution. Here you will going to find out the solution with the help of the mathematical equations. And last one is the results, or we can say the post processing. Here we can find out the contour plots for the displacement, equivalent stress, normal stress and so on. So this is the step of step for the analysis of the plate with hole. Now we will move towards the software ANSYS. This is the GOI of the ANSYS and this is the environment where all projects can be done. So there are total modules available in the ANSYS are shown here, where you can do the number of analysis. Now just click on the static structural analysis, double click, you can double click on the static structural analysis or simply single click and drag and drop in the GOI. It will take some time. So this is the analysis. You can rename this analysis, just simply right click on the static structural, click on rename. You can write here name the analysis for plate with hole. I write here three hole. Sorry, yes, okay. Then we will go step by step. First of all, the engineering data, it means there is need to provide the material properties for the plate. So which type of material you are going to use? So by default, in the ANSYS, the structural steel properties are given here. You can add the number of materials from the library. Now we will check the properties here. The Young's modulus is, first of all, I want to change the unit from Pascal to Megapascal. The Young's modulus is 2 into 10 raised to power 5, that is nothing but 200 gigapascal, and the Poisson's ratio is 0.3. So this is nothing but the properties of structural steel which is required for the analysis of plate. So therefore, just to go back to home or go back to your project, simply click on the project. Then the second step is to prepare a model, that is nothing but geometry. So right click on the geometry, click on new design modeler geometry. The new window will open to prepare a model. To open every new window, So answers will take some time. It is open now. So this is the modeler environment. You can prepare any type of model, whatever you have to do the analysis. Now here we are going to analyze the plate. First of all, change the unit which unit you require. I want unit millimeter. Go to the XY plane. Here total three axes shown. In the, that is nothing but the 3D environment. I want to change it into the 2D environment. Just click on the XY plane. Simply click on look at. Okay. So now two axes are shown only. So just go to the sketching. Click on rectangle. Just draw here. Okay. Then click on the dimensions. General. Simply click on the line, vertical and horizontal. If you want a center distance, then click on horizontal, select two vertical lines here, and for vertical distance, simply select two horizontal lines. See, so you will get the center distance for the vertical and horizontal dimension. Simply edit all the dimensions here. So H1, this, that is nothing but the dimension is 100, H3, 50, V2 is 50, and V4 is 25. So this is the rectangle. Now I want to prepare a hole. So for that, just click on the draw circle. Just you can draw a first circle at the center, then two circles beside that center hole. So R is given, so it means the radius is same. So give the dimension again. Dimension, first of all I want to give the horizontal dimension between the centers. So this distance is 25, this is also 25, and the next dimension is the diameter. I want to give the diameter for all the holes. So by default the radius of both the circles are same, so if I will give the dimension to this circle, then it will be over constrained. So diameter of this circle is 15 mm. And diameter of this small circle is 10 mm. So now sketching is completed. You can go to the modeling. Then if it is a 2D analysis, just go to the concept, surface from sketch. Click on surface from sketch. Then click on this plus sign in the XY plane, select sketch. Complete sketch has been selected. Apply. Give the thickness here. I want to give the thickness 1 mm. And just simply click on generate. So it is converted into the plate now. Okay, so this is the modeling, that is nothing but the geometry. So just you can close the this window now, the design modeler window. Now here that right click is there. So next step, that third step is model. Model is nothing but the meshing in the ANSYS. Okay, so now we are in the new window for the meshing, boundary condition and solution. Okay, just you can see here the that model plate is came into that analysis environment now, that imported into the analysis environment. So you can just right click over that one, go to the view and front view. Okay, and to see here as 2D plate. Now simply click right click on the mesh, and you can simply click generate mesh. so that the ANSYS will use the automatic meshing, and by considering the complexity of the geometry, the ANSYS use the element automatically. So you can see here where the geometry is critical, the number of elements are more, and the element used is as a quadrilateral element. Okay, so if you can increase the number of element, just click on the mesh, go to the details of mesh below that one, click on the sizing, just use adaptive size. You can click on yes on the adaptive size. Okay, when you are click on the yes, here it is shown as resolution. Just simply click over here. You can increase the level of resolution. So instead of 2, by default it is taken as 2. I want to taken as 5. And again, just click on the mesh, right click, update or generate mesh again. So the number of elements will increase. So by increasing the number of resolution, level of resolution, the number of elements will increase. Okay, so these are the number of elements, increase in the number of elements. You can see the statistics here. The total nodes are 3679 and the elements are 3374. So I want to reduce that element because these are very high element. So you again go to the resolution, just reduce the element level. I just put it up to the 3. Okay, and again click on right click on and update. So this is the third level. So now the number of elements are 1250 and number of nodes are 1402. But here is the hole. So obviously the stress is occurred where the area is less. Area is less. So I want to refine that area where the area is less. So go to the mesh again. Right click on the mesh. Insert and just click on the refinement. Okay, so you have to select that area. I select a edge, click on the edges 1, 2, and 3 and simply apply. Okay, now you can check here the refinement level also. So I want to increase that refinement level. The refinement level can increase up to 3. So I want to use the level 3. Again click on the mesh and update it or generate mesh. Okay, so here you can check the number of elements near the holes are increased. So this is the refined mesh. Okay, now the next step is the static structural, that is nothing but to apply the boundary condition. So I just for that we have to use the edges. Just select that left edge. If you are going to you can right click also, or if you click on the static structural, you can show the boundary conditions are here. So I want to fix that edge. Just click on the fix, that complete edge has been fixed in all direction, and click on that next edge and click here above force. Okay, and instead of vectors I want the components, that is x, y and z component. You can see this is x y plane. So in this direction it is x positive, this is x negative, this is y positive, this is y negative. So I want to apply a force on the x direction, that is in the negative direction as per the given problem. So it is -1000. Okay, you can check the force is applied here. So if you click on the static structure, you can see the boundary condition that B is fixed support, so that edge has been fixed, and A is the 1000 and that force is applied over that edge. Okay, now just last step is to solver. So solution, if you click on the solution, that complete analysis has been solved, and you can check here building mathematical model, means ANSYS are going to build a mathematical model for every element at the backend side. Okay, so it has been solving now, and it is solved. Now, the post processing, that is results. Okay, the results in the finite element analysis are shown in the contour plot. So, you what results you want? I want a total deformation. I want equivalent stress. I want normal stress in x and y direction. Normal stress in x and y direction. So normal stress, first of all, check here x direction. Second normal stress, there is need to change direction. Here it's y direction. Okay. Now it is simply click on the solve. You will get the contour plot for all the deformations. Check. So this is the deformation. Here you can see the red zone. That red zone is shown as the maximum deformation over the plate. Now, if we check the animation, you can see that circular hole are going to be oval after the compression. So the blue color indicates that it is a less deformation. So it is the position. It is completely blue. Then it is going to compressed. Okay. So this is the deformation. Now normal stress in the x direction, you can see, you can check the normal stress in x direction. So maximum stress occurred at red portion. Just click on the probe, and if I click here, so it is -3. Here it is -3. So the maximum stress may be occurred max here. It is -4. So it is -4, or it is 1.13 megapascal. Okay, so the maximum stress will always be occur where the area is minimum, and the stress in the lateral direction, that is in the y direction, if the force is applied longitudinally, how the stress is occurred in the lateral direction, that is nothing but the normal stress in y direction. So here the maximum stress has been occurred. So this is the stresses in the normal direction. Now we can check the stress intensity also. Just click on the right click on the solution, go to the stress, and here you can check the intensity. So simply click on the solve. So this is the stress intensity. You can check the animation for that one. So this is the contour plot for the solution of finite element analysis. Okay, so this is the analysis for the plate with the three hole. Now in the next lecture we come with the any other type of analysis over the mechanical component. So thank you very much.